So I'm ready to drill. I've got to drill on the back side first. And so here I got my drill press set up here, and you can see I got my support plywood that's resting on both of these extensions, and this is clamped to this. And you know, since I made the second one, I've got just the ability to just deal with these big, long, heavy, awkward pieces like I never dreamed of in, you know, a whole lifetime of woodwork and now adult lifetime. And here's my new squishy pad to stand on that I made. And I'm loving it. The price was right. Let me show you what I've got here. I've just got, you know, a board. This is just a reference board. I've used this thing for years. Piece of poplar. It's milled real straight, even though it's kind of ugly and has a lot of holes and paint on it. It's real straight and true. And so I'm just gonna, you know, open the hole up with a 3/32 on the back side. And then I'll flip it over and can do proper drilling on the other side, down on the plywood deck. But I have to drill through to in correspondence with my punch holes, my transfer punch holes.
I just sharpened this drill bit so it's doing real well. Yeah, I should move the wood and not try to move the metal on the wood. Okay, this is the one that I just was able to push in. I wasn't able to actually wrap it. So I want to be real careful. I should probably get a punch and open that hole up just a little bit. I'm going to open this hole up just a little bit with a punch, but I'm not going to do it up here on the drill press. I don't want to bang up on top of my drill press. So that other one, that's good enough. I can find that one, but this one was just basically just dimpling into the paint. Normally I'm not that fussy with metal particles, but I don't want the hot particles to melt into this paint that's still pure in here. Here's just a small fraction of the latest batch of super high grade bolts and nuts that I got from my buddy August in Chicago. 141 pounds showed up at my door of incredible hardware, and got it all sorted out. So I'm using some of the, this is 1/4 inch and 5/16 here, but everything's going, is just popping right on here, just perfect. You know, I've got the first ones in here, the cast iron. Now over here in the wood, it's going really well too. So just make sure I grab enough of these. So my transfer punch method, you know, it just worked perfect. Getting it up there, holding it in place. And since, you know, the holes are a little bit oversized on this back side, and if I can get it just right, I know it's gonna have to come off one more time because I still have to drill, I have to mark the holes over here. I have to mark these holes here for where my, mark them off the back side for that. You know, there's three holes here that are going to hold this sliding table assembly up.
But I did not want to mark those until I get this dialed in absolutely perfect. Then I'll use my transfer punch again, and I'll mark those three holes, take it off and drill them, and then I can put it back on and it should be for good. But I just want to make sure that I can really dial this thing in absolutely perfect before I put those in. So I'm gonna just bolt this guy together and put my tubing back on. So I got all my bolts in there. They all just kind of slid in nice and aligned. So I'm gonna bolt this thing together, and then I'm gonna put my tubing on it, and then I'm gonna rack it and make sure that I can really get my height right. And if I can do that, then I'll take the tubing off and I'll mark those holes over here and drill them, those three holes for the sliding table support. And I have to take it off to drill it. You know, I can't do it here. I don't try to drill this kind of stuff freehand. That's drill press work. Okay, this is the setup I'm going to use over here for the wood. I'm going to have these fender washers. I'm going to have two fender washers and then a quarter inch washer and a lock nut and lock washer and then a nut on top on the back side of this. And that's just going to keep from this just eating into the wood. And so it's going to distribute that weight and just, you know, make things better. And yeah, I did that on the other side somewhat. I should probably change that out at some point. And then, you know, here on the cast iron part, you know, it's just going to be a grade 8 lock washer, washer and nut. That's all that's going to need, because that's not going to compress. But I want to show you a really simple way. So these fender washers that I've got here, you know, these are just, you can see they're junk. I don't even know where they came from, but they're not big enough. They're not the right size. They're too small a opening. But I want to show you a really simple way to open up washers really quickly. And so you can, if you just get into your junk box, but you need a washer with a little bit bigger size, you know, it's really difficult to figure out how to hold something like that without, causing a problem. But I'm going to show you right now how I do it. Okay, so I'm going to drill out these holes really quick. I'm going to drill them out a 1/64 bigger than a quarter, so I have, you know, a little bit of room. A lot of times you kind of raise a burr on these two. So you just want to take your tongue and groove pliers and get them at a nice comfortable setting here to where you can grab that washer really good, you know, without having to put too much strain on it. So you can see I still got plenty of, all I have to do is just put a little bit of tension here and I've really got a good grip on it. And then the key is to have a piece of wood that's narrower than your washer is wide. So you've got a flat deck that you can set that on. And then you just go to town and drill. There you go, don't touch it, it's hot. It's always best just to do one size and then switch your pliers to the next size, so you don't have to constantly be jumping back and forth. But you can see now I've still got plenty of, I got just enough pinch here where it's very, very easy for me to hold and control this. I could have probably gone with a little bit smaller piece, or a little bit bigger piece of wood, but I'm not going to bother. I'm just going to make this work. Technique that'll, you know, just keep you from having to run out to the hardware store.